see between Lift and Fight. Here is the eighth round, exactly as it will happen. Clay comes out to meet Liston, and Liston starts to retreat. If Liston goes back an inch farther, he'll end up in the ringside seat. Clay swings with his left. Clay swings with his right. Look at young Cassius Clay the fight. Liston keeps backing, but there's not enough room. It's a matter of time, and Clay wants the boom. Now Liston gets the first in view. The crowd is getting frantic, but our radar station can pick him up. He is summarized over the Atlantic. Liston is still rising, and the ref wears a frown, but he can't start counting till Sonny comes down. Who would have thought when they came to the fight that they had witnessed the launching of a human satellite? Yes, the crowd did not dream when they put down their money that they would see a total eclipse of the sun.
Cassius Clay was a 7-1 underdog against the unbeaten and seemingly unbeatable Sonny Liston.
People forget with Sonny Liston and Clay that in the lead up to that fight, a lot of fighters, and the way they were talking about Foreman before the Ali fight in 74, and also the way we talked about Mike Tyson, people were thinking Sonny Liston was the greatest heavyweight boxer of all time, certainly the most brutal. And there was a general feeling that he was just a class above every other fighter in the land. No one gave Clay a chance.
He was a superbly strong man from all accounts, a terrific puncher, and he'd been knocking out his opponents one after the other. And he'd do the same with Cassius Clay.
Seemingly unconcerned by his critics' scant respect for his chances, the Lip gave Liston a barrage of trash talk.
Man, I don't get hit. I'm the fastest thing on 2 feet, man. You crazy? I'm tired of talking.
Listen, the champion just made an offer. $100 a round to spar with him. And you can only, and you can get in shape besides.
Well, I make a better offer than that. I don't fight the champ for nothing. I don't care how small the ring is. I'll fight that chump in a telephone booth.
All right, if you want me, you tell it to your camera, your TV man, your radio man, and you, my friend, the whole world. If Sonny Liston looks me, I'll kick his feet in the rain. I'm not out of the rain. All I need, tell him he's the greatest that kept the next cat out of the country.
This bout, 15 rounds for the heavyweight championship of the world. The challenger from Louisville, Kentucky, wearing white trunks with red stripes, weighing 210 and 1.5 pounds, the former Olympic light heavyweight champion, Cassius Clay. Clay! And his opponent from Denver, Colorado, weighing 218 pounds, wearing the black trunks with the white trim, the heavyweight champion of the world, Charles Sonny Liston. Liston!
Cassius Clay on the move, as we see, looking to get Sonny to run, carrying his left hand dangerously low. Note that the champion, Liston, the aggressive man, a good heavy shot right under the heart. Sonny has to set the pace. That's the way it looks at the outset. Cassius, that's his best. Good long left lead that might keep the champion a bit off balance. Clay still in the danger zone, but he's keeping his hands low. But you'll notice one thing, if you don't mind, he's at long range with the hands low. We're halfway through round one. Sanders really does want to look hard at this point, because behind your side, Sonny will be the guy that will keep pulling away. 1 minute more on the first round. Sonny seems to be trying to slip those left leads, can't do it too successfully because the challenger has got it all over body, and a right hand, the best touch of the fence so far.
First round, Clay continued to dance around the champion, picking him off from long range as the second round developed.
Had to rip toward the body, try to bring the guard down, then go upstairs. You know, when the body goes, the head follows. Watch out. But this youngster has his own style, and it's confusing for the champion to fathom this early in the fight, at least up to now. Halfway through the second round. The champion is flooding away, and then, of course, the challenger has to move him away. Less than 1 minute more in the second round. Use it as a left lead, a lead to other shots if he can get this kid to stand still and then rip the body. Ten seconds more in the second round. The crowd's gonna roar in a few more seconds, that's for sure.
Gaining in confidence, Clay is ready to open up on Liston in the third round.
Two. getting hit with all the punches in the book.
Was finding it more and more difficult to pin down the fast and elusive Clay.
Turned it short to a good hook.